Well, his name definitely was Chris. Buddy had the right idea, but he put about 8 pounds of Bondo on there, so it's weird because I've sanded that smooth, but I can still feel the transition. We'll keep going at it. Might require some spot filling. Okay, I got her down to the original damage. I just gotta find out where I'm at. I can sort of feel it. It's weird. Especially there. I think it's gonna need spot filling. Bummer. Even with all that big pile of Bondo, it needs a finer grade of fill. Okay, I guess I'll talk a little bit about how I'm going to make this go away and what I'm going to use. So if you saw the other video, there was that big puke mark on there. And unfortunately, that filler is too coarse for the fine damage that's been done to the surface. So I need to get spot putty. I go to the Newfie Speed and Sport. They don't have any. They haven't had any for weeks. This is like the biggest. I gotta go someplace else and find spot putty. But what I really need to do in order to figure out where I'm at is I'm gonna spray this lightly with the red that I have, which I'm sure is probably pretty close, because they wouldn't get into a custom color. It's some sort of manufacturer's red, but manufacturers make a lot of different red. Back to what this is. This would probably be post-catalyzed polyurethane. And we have some of this. This is pre-catalyzed polyurethane. Yeah, post-catalyzed stuff is stuff that has two parts that you mix together. And the reason that they like to use that in a manufacturing setup is because it gets hard really fast and you're done. And it lasts a long time on the shelf. So does lacquer, but if you want a real good, hard, tough finish with lacquer, it has to sit. It's fast as far as drying goes and workability. But to get that really bulletproof sort of, you know, hit it with a hammer and bounce off thing, it won't happen. So anyhow, for touch-up purposes, yes, Dave has let the cat out of the bag. You can mix lacquer with polyurethane and get away with it. They will like each other for the most part. Okay, let's see what happens. I gotta mask this whole thing. Oh yeah, the other thing is I'm just going to shoot the whole face of the guitar. The pick guard covers so much. There's really, you know, I'll just cut it right at the radius, right at the bend. So let's get masking. This is the book that I was looking through to show that other stuff about tremolo locking things. This isn't a bad book. I really wouldn't recommend it. Well, I'll recommend it if you can get a used copy and don't pay full price. It's got a lot of good info, but it really has a lot of gaps in it too. And maybe I'll get some shots of some other books that I have. I have a lot of guitar repair books. 14-day masking tape. I think that's the shelf life of this masking tape. I don't think... Oh, where is my shop dummy? He's not here. To find the shop dummy, he's not here. But he's not here. It's bagged. You can also read the back of it while you're on the toilet. Just remember, folks, from the motion picture, Scott Pilgrim versus the World, or as we called it, Scott Pilgrim versus the Accountants. And I found this guy, my Friday hammer. Actually, these days it's pretty much an everyday hammer, essential toolkit. They don't sell this one at Stumac.
They're shipping out the wrong hammer. I gotta get a hold of them. Unfortunately, my area for spraying is a bit of a disaster zone at the moment, so stand by while I get the shop dummy all over this. It reminds me of an episode of Saw. So I had some crap in the bottom of the airbrush bottle. There's all kinds of shit in that bottle. See, that's why new bottles, new colors every time. And it's killing me already. But hey, I have this shit. I didn't have to go to the store. Well, I had to go to the store and get beer. But okay, so that's it. I can now figure out where the defects are, so it'll be another day. This is done for today, and I gotta get Spot Putty. I can't believe it. Just like anything useful, no one has. All they have is the stuff they want you to buy, not the stuff you really want or need. Cripe. Oh yeah, and it'll give me a chance to filter all the shit out of my red collar. It's a minor disaster. I really hadn't anticipated screwing around with that. So these are the three main books I use to look shit up, if anybody gives a damn. Guitar and Amp Maintenance, not to be confused with Guitar Repair. That light's killing me. It's a different deal. This is more all about acoustic guitars. And this is like super duper old school. It's where I stole a lot of ideas for building guitars. And this is great for anybody who has amps. Especially it's more electronic than it is guitar setup wise. It's more about that end of it. This is an okay guide. The second edition's better. It's easier to read. I just find the print in the other edition sucks. Okay, a couple more super cool books. Hold on. History of Marshall. The thing about this book is it has in the back every schematic for every Marshall amp ever made. Then I've got specialty books for different guitars, you know, depending on what I'm working on. This is a great one. It talks about all the different knobs and wiring and changes, and it's, you know, anything you ever want to know about a Telecaster. And once again, more specialty books. Trying to hone in on what we care about. Anyhow, I showed you my three main books, and that's basically all I ever use if I forget what I need to know, or need to know something I forget.